And it is time to talk about the birds and the bees. So let's bring in the scientist with all the answers. The science behind sex. It's Dr. Karl.
Hello. Good morning.
Now, Dr. Karl, we know that Con has 8 children, so he's obviously quite adept at sex.
I have 3, one of each sex.
Why do
And you're wearing this shirt in honour of the third?
Yeah. Like the Angelina Jolie when he says. Is there... Do humans have sex apart from... Is it just an instinct to reproduce the species?
Or it is an instinct, but the evolutionary biology reason is that we try to make sure that the babies are different from the parents. So there are creatures that survive without having sex. So there's the whiptail lizard...
Or me after marriage.
Yeah.
Just give it time. Give it time.
Look, a year or two will be fine. So the whiptail lizards are all female. The entire population, and they give birth to females, which then give birth to more females.
How do they have babies then, if they don't have sex?
Well, it's called...
Does the stalk
On one hand, you call it virgin birth. On the other hand, you call it parthenogenesis, which is not giving birth to a large Greek building, but, in fact, virgin birth. So the females give birth to females, which give birth to females. The advantage is that every individual has more babies, and so the population increases very rapidly. The disadvantage is they're all identical. And so with climate change, when the environment changes, either they migrate or they die. Whereas with humans, they're all different. Some are taller, shorter, better to do low oxygen, high oxygen, etc. So from an evolutionary point of view, we have sex so the babies are different from us.
Well, can I ask a question, Dr. Karl?
That's my job.
The older girl lizards,
yep.
Where do they get the special wings from?
The eggs, they make eggs. Yeah. And the eggs, instead of having half the chromosomes, have all of them. So the so they're all clones of each other. They're all identical.
They're all identical.
They're twins.
I don't want to get competitive, but are there other species that are better at having sex than humans?
Practically all of them.
Oh. What do you mean by better?
Yeah.
Well,
you mean faster?
I just get that all the time. Well, I can do it in 30 seconds.
I think if you're doing it properly, you're doing it real fast.
The lions can do it for 40 times in 12 in 24 hours.
Wow.
For how long?
40, yeah. They've got a special lock and key mechanism. And so they just keep on going for 24 hours, 40 times.
But how long does it last?
15 minutes.
15
My
minutes?
God.
Yeah, each time.
Do animals have sex for pleasure like we do?
Bonobos do.
What are bonobos?
They're a primate, a two-legged guy. And, oh, here they are. And they use sex all the time. So if I was a bonobo, I'd say, Ida, could you pass me a cup of tea and can we have some sex? And you'd say yes. And so they have
not
sex...
Not here.
No, no. But, so they have sex all the time, everywhere, on any occasion. Here's a banana, shall we have sex? Sure.
Wow.
Isn't it true dolphins are the same? Dolphins have sex for pleasure like humans do?
They do, but the dolphins are not quite the wonderful, elevated creatures, but rather they actually attack the females and are mean to them, and they're not quite as lovely as they say in the literature.
So like sex in your 20s, basically.
What literature you've been reading?
Everything.
Yeah. This is really fascinating. You're doing the whole science behind sex kind of chatting about what are you doing? Are you doing a discussion tonight?
Yeah.
And there is actually a way you can, by looking at your fingers, determine how fertile you are.
So this is for the guys. For the guys, put your right hand up. Right hand up, all the guys. Now, you've got the little finger, and the one next to that is called the fourth finger. Yeah. Compare the length of the fourth finger with the second finger, which is next to your thumb. Who has got their fourth finger on their right hand, the fourth finger longer than the second finger? Put your hand up.
Yeah.
Put your hand up, one over there, ball, that's good, and ball. Okay, you guys are the high testosterone studs.
Yeah. Come on!
Yes, thank you, thank you.
Right, now, so what that means is that if...
You reckon?
So if the fourth finger is longer than the second finger and if you have a big chin and if you have a cleft in the chin, then you have a high testosterone level, you're a great lover, a lousy father. In my case, mine are practically about the same. I've got a pretty low sperm count. My sperm count is so low, I know them each by name. That's how I feel. But I'm still able to have 3 children.
Dr. Karl, you are as fascinating and charming as ever. Thank you very much for joining us. And for more details about Dr. Karl's festival discussion of sex, go to the website ultimosciencefestival.com. Dr. Karl, thanks very much.
Thank you.